is.
I said, keep the party going, and look who all showed up. Yeah! If he was here right now, which he is, he would say 5 o'clock somewhere in it, ladies and gentlemen. I think so.
In the winter time, yeah, but it's July. Get paid by the hour and over by the minute. Boss just sits over the limit. I got to call it something. I think I'll just call it a day. Pour me something tall and strong. They give it a hurricane before I go to sleep. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. You tell me, Scotty. Well, this lunch break is going to take all afternoon. Half the night. Tomorrow I know that there will be hell to pay. And that's alright. Ain't had a day off now in over a year. I should make a big case. Don't start right here, hit the phones with me. You can tell I'm out just in the way. Oh, there's something tall and strong. They hit a hurricane before I go to sleep. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. It's 5 o'clock tab, pour myself in a cab and be back to work before 2. At a moment like this, you can't help but wonder what would Jimmy Buffett do?
Fill up the Hollywood bowl.
Oh, there's something tall and strong. I get a hurricane before I go to sleep. It's only 12:30.
No, I don't care. ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Everybody out there in front of the stage, everybody here on the stage, all the wonderful folks behind the stage, you're all congregated because of one fella. Because we crossed the path of the one man nebula of positive energy that was and is Mr. Jimmy Buffett. We got a bunch of folks that want to sing for you tonight. We're going to get right into it. We're going to bring out a great friend of the band, great friend of Jimmy. We did a bunch of charity work together with him. Please welcome to the stage, Mr. Jake Owen.
He's going to sing with us.
Yeah!
Yeah! Well, howdy. Coral Reefer Ben, how about that? Well, I'm born and raised a Florida boy. I have a lot of Jimmy Buffett in my veins. He had an incredible way, as Max said, of bringing a lot of people together. And you'll see that tonight. I'm really proud to be able to be here and honor him tonight. And being a Florida boy, I know a lot about citrus. So we'll do a little grapefruit, juicy fruit for y'all.
The newest member of the Coral Reefer Band. He got the opportunity to come out last year with us with Jimmy, and this is Scotty Emerick, who grew up weaned on the early Buffett albums. He knows more of those early album cuts than Jimmy did. It was fun to watch the two of them sing together all last year. And we're all going to be at Jazz Fest not too long from now. Jimmy learned how to be Jimmy Buffett in New Orleans. We're going to borrow a little bit of New Orleans right now and see about a pencil thin mustache.
Yeah!
the ending. Don't mind if I. But if you find yourself in that night sky at the grave, honey, jump right up and show your age. I wish I had a pencil thin mustache off the lightning kind. Two-tone Ricky Ricardo jacket on a craft picture of Andy Devine. I remember being butt-toothed and skinny, riding the mail that was disguised each penny. I wish I had a pencil thin mustache that I could soften this dress down. Man's band stand living and going back, drinking on a fake ID. Everyone's a woman, but all the jazz musicians smoking marijuana. I wish I had a pencil in my stash, then I could toss in this dress too. Living room floor, so soft. I send you off to college, try to gain a little knowledge, but all you want to do is learn how to score. Now, get old, don't wear our hair, don't go to church, and I don't cut my hair. But I can go to movies and sit all there the way that it used to be. That's why I wish I had a pencil thin mustache. Sway, burn, fan, or Mac, McAnally. If I only had a pencil and mustache, then I could do some crazy too. Yeah, real pretty, a little dabble do. Oh, I could do some crazy.
Please welcome to the stage, Mr. Woody Harrelson.
A joint on the roof of the Vatican. That's not true, of course, but wouldn't that be a great story? The Pope walks in. And I do have a lot of great stories with Jimmy, but unfortunately, someone robbed my memory bank. Jimmy Buffett is synonymous with Margaritaville.
Yeah!
You probably think of him as this guy in flip-flops hopping from one exotic island to the next, but like me, he was just a boy from the South with a beautiful head of hair. Jimmy got his start busking on the streets of New Orleans. As the years went on, his music got bigger, but he never forgot where he came from. His Gulf Coast pride ended up being the very thing that helped him create a new brand, new genre of music, and hotels, and restaurants, and old folks' homes. I mean, where do you want to go? Anyway, here to take us back to Jimmy's roots, is one of the great country artists of our time, Kenny Chesney.
Thank you, everybody. Thanks for having me. Yeah. Well, you guys have a blast tonight.
Back where I come from. Back where I come from.
sunshine too. I know who made the moonshine too. That's where I come from. Blue eyes on a Saturday night. 10 legs in the broad daylight. TVs, they were black and white. Back where I come from. Point to say that's where I come from.
Jimmy Buffett was a dear, dear friend of mine, and I know they're having a tribute concert, and I'd give anything in this world if I could be there with everybody tonight to celebrate Jimmy. I know he's looking down and thinking, what are you people doing? Did you all have a margarita? And sure, we did, most of us, right? Anyway, I just wanted to say that I love Jimmy like all of you do. I mean, what a great human being he was. What a great talent he was. What a sweet, sweet soul. And a lot of people probably don't even know that he wrote books and every sort of thing. You know, you just thought he was just like one of these people in flip-flops. But he was a brilliant person and a good heart. And I know the show's going to be great tonight. And again, I'm just sorry that I'm going to miss it. But Jimmy, we love you! Oh, here's to you. Dear, everybody raise your eyes to Jimmy.
Please welcome to the stage a voice from Jimmy's last album, which is a force, Miss Angelique Kidjo. Please welcome her. Angelique's gonna rock it.
Thank you. try. The magic kind of this, got no doctor to prescribe. Well, there's a
Joey.
The quest for the lost shipper of salt marches on. Dear, who is my weapon? Panama City Beach. Thousands of adoring fans gather to catch a glimpse of Jimmy Buffett and the Coral Reapers, veteran ambassadors of live music and good times, as they complete another stop on their world tour.
Ladies and gentlemen, Captain Buffett is advising that you remain in your seats with your seatbelts fastened.
Margarita, cheeseburger.
Jimmy Buffett was a cool guy.
Yeah!
I remember one day at a long, some might say boozy lunch with Jimmy and Ed Bradley. It was Bradley's birthday. I saw both of them had earrings. So right after lunch,
so we just need a do-si-do.
I got my earrings.
Yeah, it's in my
earrings. That's just how infectious Jimmy's coolness. Infectious enough for a 40-year-old man to spontaneously get his fucking ear pierced.
And infectious enough to create an entire culture.
Yeah!
There's no other way to say it. There will never be another like Jimmy.
Yeah!
Woo! Usually cool guys are not that nice. Jimmy was more than nice. He was kind.
Yeah!
He was beloved. by his family, by his friends, by his band, his crew, and his collaborators, and he loved them all back.
Yeah!
Please help me welcome to the stage one of Jimmy's favorite and most frequent collaborators, the very talented Zach Brown Band.
Yeah!
What a night. What a world. So glad to have been in orbit with something so powerful. And the things that I learned from him, I could call him and I could hear advice from somebody that no one else could give. And we wrote this song for him. Here's a brand new one, y'all. It's the first time we've ever played this song out live. It's called Parrots and Parrots. It's coming out on the 19th. But it's coming out right now.
All the pirates and the parrots sing, oh.
course, my friend.
I think this is the way that Jimmy would have wanted it.
She made me leave.
Songs that's ever been. He's got a lot of them, you know. These guys have been pals a long time. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Emerick Church.
I am.
Yeah! I got to know Jimmy a few years ago. We, maybe 7 years ago now. We spent some time out every summer.
You are beautiful!
We'd go on hikes some mornings and sometimes have some afternoon wine and have lunch, and then some nights we'd have tequila till there wasn't any more tequila. Jimmy enjoyed living life more than any person enjoyed living life.
Yeah!
I remember hiking one day, and we were heading up this vista, and we start talking about music and songwriting and our careers and his life and my life and death. And he goes, you know, Emerick, he said, guys like us, we don't really die. He said, because the songs live forever. And this one will. Party going, and obviously, no one loves Jimmy
we knew he was a fighter. He would fight for you, he'd fight for your cause, whatever you did in your career and your job. I recall in the early 2000s, we're playing the Knicks here in Miami, and the game was crazy, physical, it was out of hand, technical fouls all over the place, players getting thrown out of games, and all of a sudden there's a commotion at the end of the court where Jimmy sits. The official was in his face, Jimmy was in the official's face. The next thing I know was, you're out of here. Jimmy Buffett got thrown out of the game. I chased the official down and asked him, what did he say to you? I said, do you know who that is? It's Jimmy Buffett. And he said, he called me a freaking parrot head. And I said, you feel bad for that? He said, yes, insulting me. I said, that's not an insult, that's a compliment.
Yeah!
Said, the officials, just remember, we gotta keep this party going, so let's keep the spirit of Jimmy Buffett going.
Yeah!
Well said. And speaking of parrot heads, our next guest, not only a great member of POCO, not only a former coral reefer, not only an eagle, but he's also, for all of you parrot heads out there, this is the guy that coined the phrase. He's the first man that ever said it.
Yeah.
Please welcome Timothy B. Schmidt.
Yeah. Hey, it's really great to be out here at the Jimmy's party. I am a former coral reefer band member, and I'm proud to say so. 1984, baby. And the way it happened that I got into Jimmy's band is that my band, the Eagles, had broken up. And I was doing some projects that weren't going really fast or anything. And I went to an afternoon party one day in Hollywood. And Jimmy was there. We got to talking about this and that. And he says, what are you doing this summer? And I said, I don't know, what do you got in mind? And he said, well I was thinking our bass player's not with us anymore, and I thought maybe you might want to come out with us. And I thought about it for a little bit, and by the end of the party I said, deal. So I did about 3 years with him, actually. Some of you might know if that's the right time frame or not. But I'm really happy to be here, and I want to say, parrot heads, unite.
Yeah!
I don't know where I'm gonna go.
territory. Don't land in no San Diego. Don't land in no Buzzard State. Don't land in no Mar and Lago. I got nothing more to say. Hey, I don't know.
Please welcome to the stage, Miss Jane Fonda.
The one that smoked a bowl with Jimmy on the roof of the Vatican.
Yeah! Woo!
This is a good evening, isn't it?
Yes!
Don't you all feel really good?
Yes!
That's Jimmy.
Yeah. Jimmy
has the ability to, like Tinkerbell, spread happiness all over. You know, I love what Harrison said about Jimmy Buffett, and I don't know if he used this word, but the word generous always comes to me when I think of Jimmy Buffett. He was such a generous man, generous of heart, generous of spirit. He loved people, and that's why we love him, because we could feel that. You know, even through his music, you could feel that. And so, you know, just remember that about the Vatican roof and everything. I have the honor right now to bring on the stage a woman that I admire from the bottom of my heart, one of the great American singers, who never ceases to surprise us with her style and range. It's so vast. Please welcome Brandi, Carlile! Yeah!
On Chalice, fill it up with good red wine on the street, on a honeysuckle vine.
Yeah, now the sun goes slant across the water, and the sailboat, they go searching for the breeze. Oh, that solitary stick around to your skin and make you feel fine. It's gonna make you feel fine. I wanna be there. I wanna go back down and hide beside the city.
Jimmy Buffett. Everybody's got a story about Jimmy Buffett. I love Jimmy Buffett so much, and our language that we spoke to one another was the language of fishing, which is a huge part of my life, and I could call Jimmy up and didn't matter where I was, and he had some salty dog captain come out and pick me up and take me fishing. Even if he couldn't be there, off the drop-off off of Anegado or in the Gulf, and he just treated me like gold. And he used to go out on the water and make friends with lesbian fisherwomen by telling them and that they were fishing buddies. He'd text me and he'd say, "Hey, Brandi, I met some more lesbians. I gave them your phone number. I saw them out in the Cape. The stripers ran. They're gonna call ya." Thanks, Jimmy. And I miss him, and he was so good to me, and I feel like he was good to me mostly because he knew how much I love his wife, Jane, who's one of my most precious, precious friends. He'd text me and he'd say, "This is Jimmy, Jane's husband, Brandi. I got a finger, I got some lesbians I want to go fishing with you." And he had so many Jane stories for me, and Jane used to call him Dude. And I just so deeply admired the beauty, the timelessness, and the power of their love story. Jimmy and Jane's love story is one for the ages. And so I'm really honored that even as a lesbian, I get to sing this next song. Heading up to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hot tubbies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter, rock and roll. I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by
It's been quite the summer. Red cars and westbound trains. And now you're off on vacation. Sometimes it's hard to say. Well, honey, I've been so. That's the reason I just let you go. Come on, baby, it'll be alright. Come on, baby, I'll be holding you tight. I've spent four lonely days around LA. Just want you back by my side. Not much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana, we scouted up in the wind for
I hope you're enjoying the scenery. Yeah, I know it's pretty out there. We can go hiking next Tuesday. With you, I could walk anywhere. California has warmed me quite thin. Oh, I just can't wait to see you again. Come on, baby, it'll be alright.
I wish I could be there with you tonight if I had been there. Matter of fact, I'm a little bit disappointed that you decided to have this event when you know I'm in Australia. And I think you did that on purpose. But the last time Jimmy Buffett played the Hollywood Bowl was in 2015, and I don't know if any of you were there that night, but I can guarantee you had a good time. And I bet you're having a good time tonight, though, even though we're missing him. And that's because that's the main thing. Jimmy liked it best when everybody was having a good time. That was his gift. He showed us how to enjoy ourselves. So bless your heart for being there tonight. I wish I was there. And, you know, hello from Perth. The same place.
Well, you know, Jimmy's here, but we're going to use your imaginations just a little bit because you know exactly what he'd be doing in this next song. He would be bouncing up and down on a giant inflatable cheeseburger is what he would be doing.
Yeah!
Just a cheese.
banners and daiquiris, but that American creation of which I mean, cheeseburger in paradise.
Welcome to the stage, Will Arnett.
Wow. Yep. Exactly the person you expected to see. Woo! I gotta tell you what, I'm so honored to be here celebrating the great Jimmy Buffett.
Yeah!
Reminded in times like these that every time we lose somebody said it before, we still have their memories. And then whenever we talk about them, we breathe more life into those memories and they become even bigger. Right? And I have so many memories of Jimmy and Jane and the kids and my kids. All of us together, so many awesome memories. And I was thinking today about one that stuck out. Years ago, I was down, Jane Fonda was talking about Jimmy's generosity. Jimmy and Jane had been so good to me over the years, and I was staying with them down in the Caribbean. And I woke up one morning, and Jimmy was getting ready to go somewhere. And if you knew Jimmy, you knew that he was either coming from somewhere or going somewhere. Often at the same time. And I said, Jimmy, where are you going? And he said, I gotta go get certified for the takeoff and landing at the St. Barts Airport. Now, the St. Barts Airport is death-defying. It's like a controlled crash, and it's scary. And he said, I gotta go and I gotta get certified. I gotta go do a bunch of takeoff and landings, like 30 of them. He said, you want to go? And I said, yeah, of course I want to go. He said, great, I'll just go get my stuff. And he left the room. Jane turned to me and she said, dude, Jimmy has been in like 3 plane crashes. You're not going with him. So I bailed. So yeah, we're left with our memories. And luckily for us, in Jimmy's case, we're also left with his music.
Yes!
So, here to play Bob Dylan's favorite Jimmy Buffett song, He Went to Paris. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Jackson Brown.
Woo!
Thank you. Thank you. It's so great to be here with you tonight. First time I ever got to share a stage with Jimmy was in Calaveras County. And he did that show with a broken leg. Big smile you ever saw. The next time I got to be on stage with him was probably 50 years later, and I opened for him in a stadium, a football stadium in Detroit. This is a song that Jimmy wrote for a friend of his who had been in the Spanish Civil War and had survived that and went on to go live in Europe, only to lose his family in World War II. And he knew this guy in Chicago, but in the last chapter of the song, he gave him a last chapter in his life of a life in the Caribbean, which is what he would want for himself or what he would want for any of us too. He went to Paris looking for answers, questions about learning so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, saving the world on his own. The warm summer breezes, the French wines and cheese, but his ambition that day. Summers and winters scattered like splinters 4 or 5 years ago. He went to England, played the piano, married an actress named Kim. They had a fine life, she was a good wife, bore him a son named Jim. In all of those questions without an answer, he locked in his agony. He liked the choir, intention was 20 more years than the rain. Took his baby, the bombs killed his lady, left him with only one eye. His body was battered, his whole world was shattered, and all he could do was just cry. While the tears were falling, he was recalled. There were answers that he never found. Skidded the ocean, left England without sound. I lives in the islands, dishes the piles, drinks his green lake on each day. Writing his memoirs, losing his hero, but he don't care what most people say. Through 86 years of perpetual motion,
It likes you to smile and say, Jim, some of it's magic, some of it's tragic, but I had it written on all the way. He went to Karen, looking for answers to questions
that bothered him so.
Thank you, Jimmy. Let's keep the party going.
Jackson Brown.
Yeah!
We're going to take this opportunity to brag on Jimmy, a song that he actually wrote last year. Now, Jimmy didn't have to prove anything as a songwriter since about 1971. Everybody knew what he was. He was a man. But in 2023, he worked his ass off on some songs, and we're going to do one of them for you now. We're going to bring out Miss Caroline Jones, who's going to help us with that.
Yes!
There. And it came about, Jimmy's always been great for our troops. We were playing a charity show for the Navy, and Admiral Best from the Navy was sitting in with us, and he made the mistake of telling Jimmy, if there's ever anything the Navy can do for you, Jimmy's eyes lit up even more than they're already lit up. Yeah, I got something. He wanted to do this test that the Navy SEALs do, where they strap you into the cage of a helicopter, full gear, helmet, strapped up, everything, and drop you into 30 feet of water like you had a helicopter crash. Jimmy Buffett's bucket list was considerably different than mine. But Admiral Best said, if that's what you want, Jimmy, we'll do it for you. I'm not going to baby you, though. You're going to have to do it the way we do it. Jimmy said, that's all I want, but I want advice. Admiral Best said, well, when you get down there at the bottom of that water and you're strapped up, you're going to freak out. You're not going to know where you are. You're going to just totally lose everything. And when that happens, follow the bubbles. They'll take you up where you need to go. And this is a testament to what a songwriter the guy was, because that's really specific advice about an even more specific situation that none of us are ever going to be in. But he took that and he wrote a song that I believe applies to everybody in the Hollywood Bowl this evening. This is Bubbles Up. When this world starts a-reeling from that pressure drop feeling, we're just treading water these days. There's a way to feel better, be well set to weather the storm till the sun shines again. When your compass is spinning and you're lost on the way, like a leaf in the wind, friend, hear me when I say, bubbles up, they will point you toward home. No matter how deep and how far you roam, they will show you the surface, the plot and the purpose. So when the journey is long, just know that you are loved. There is light up above. Joy, there's always reason now. Bubbles up. My friends who are jolly,
when melancholy,
sometimes
sometimes living is trouble.
troubles up.
We'll put you to George Hall. Don't matter how deep or how far you roam. They will show you the service, the plot and the purpose. So when the journey gets long, just know that you
next fellow is a jack of all trades in the music business. He's written hits for the Eagles. He's written hits for Linda Ronstadt. He's written hits for himself and James Taylor. I met him singing on the Coconut Telegraph album back in about 1980. Please welcome to the stage, J.D. Salvador.
Sweet moment, but I have to say it's much lighter by made much lighter by the amount of love in this bowl.
Yeah,
I've been in the Hollywood Bowl a lot of times. In fact, Jackson Brown and I used to have little bungalows right over the hill on Camrose Court, and before we had any money, we'd sneak up, sit in the trees, and watch people play down here. Anyway, when Mac asked me to do Southern Cross, I thought, I guess I agree with you. I thought it was a great idea because Jimmy Buffett, besides the fact that Jimmy and Jane had been great friends of mine for 50 years or more, and you couldn't ask for two better friends or more generous or loving people. But Jimmy's also the first person who got me onto a sailboat. I'm a flatlander from Amarillo, Texas. I had no idea. And he threw me in with a buddy of his named Jack West. We got on a 39-foot Troy Lee. Sailed up the Inland Waterway around Florida and into Key West, where, as you know, Jimmy is the unofficial emperor. And I'm going to do, as he says sometimes on stage, we're going to do some sailing songs for you.
Thank you, everybody. Keep the party going.
Well,
I hope so, but I don't think so.
This is a song that I used to actually struggle to get Jimmy to put this song in the set. He always called me the token Southern Baptist in the Coral Reefer Band. And it's kind of true, but I think this is an important song from a songwriting standpoint. When Jimmy wrote this song, there had never been a song in country music like this one. He just wrote what people had been implying for three or four decades. He did not imply it. We'll give it a try. Jimmy hadn't become an icon, he could have played college frat gigs for the rest of his life off that one song right there. I think, well, we're in LA, it's Hollywood. It seems like it'd be an awfully nice time to see Snoop Dogg. What's happening?
With so much drama in the LBC, it's kinda hard being Snoop Dogg double G. But I somehow, some way, keep coming up with funky ass shit like every single day. Make I kick a little something from the cheese can. Make a few ends as I breeze through. It's 2 in the morning and I'm 40 still jumping cause my mama ain't home. I got bitches in the living room getting it on and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning. So what you wanna do? Shit, I got a pocket full of rubbers and my homeboys do too. So turn on the lights and close the doors. But what? Yeah. So we gon' smoke an ounce of this. Cheese up, hold down while you motherfuckers bounce to this. We smoke it.
Sippin' on gin and juice.
What everybody saying?
Rolling down the street with smoking in yo. Sippin' on gin and juice.
Lay back. And now that I've got me some Seagram gin, everybody got they cups but they ain't chipped in. Now this types of shit, it happens all the time. You gotta get yours, homie, I gotta get mine. Everything is fine when you listen to the D.O.G. I got the cultivated music that be captivating me. Who listens to the word that I speak as I take me a drink to the middle of the street and get to make it to this freak named Sadie. She used to be this man's lady. Now it was 80 degrees when I turned that trick, please. Raise the focus in your teeth, then you miss none of these at 80. As I mind up the dog pound, feel the breeze, and now you know I'm just rolling. We smoking. Play that shit, yeah. With my mind on my money, and my money on my mind. Strolling down the street, we smoking. Just sipping on gin and juice. Lay it back. You know what? Now later on that day, my homie Dr. Trey came through with a dagger tangle ring and a badass J, a suburbanic chronic that made me choke. Shit, this ain't no joke. I had to back up off a bit and sit my cup down. Take a ring and chronic, yeah, I'm fucked up now. But it ain't no stopping. I'm still popping. And Dre got some bitches from the city of Compton to serve me, but not with a cherry on top. When I bust my nut, I'm raising the popping cock. Don't get upset, girl, that's just how it goes. If we don't love you hoes, I'm out the dope. And I'll be rolling down the street. Just sipping on gin and juice. Lay back. Want my mind on my money, and my money on my mind. Rolling down the street, we smoking in God. I'm so laid back. With my mind on my money, and my money on my mind. Rolling down the street, we smoking in God.
Sipping on gin and juice.
Yes. With my mind on my money, and my money on my mind.
Rolling down the street, we smoking in the sipping on gin and juice.
Can somebody say ho? Jimmy Buffett, you know I love you. I'ma smoke this motherfucker to the head. Last time I seen you, we smoked till there wasn't no tomorrow. I love you, my brother. Peace and love from the big D on Double G.
Sit down. Clear out the stage right now and give some light to my little brother from Hawaii, Mr. Jake Schimmel. I tell you, he is so good and such a wonderful human being. But this man could be half as good as he is and he would still be the best in the world at his instrument. Jimmy Buffett loved him. I love him. You're about to love him if you don't already. This is Jay.
Everyone having a good time. Aloha. I'm so grateful to be here.
There's an old saying that my grandmother used to say to me, it's Okage Samade, which means I am what I am because of you. And all of us are who we are today because of the magic of the great Jimmy Buffett.
Yeah!
So thrilled, so honored. Thank you so much. We love you, Jimmy. You gotta help me with this one.
Kelly, quit stepping on their feet. Kelly, step on their feet. Maybe give them a, like, shake it a little bit.
I tried. I had to make myself look in.
I had three guys drop my ass.
Thank you.
God.
Please welcome John McEnroe.
Yeah.
You. So Jimmy and I were smoking a joint on the center court of Wimbledon. Woody stole my line, man.
No!
I mean, it's... God, it's incredible they'd be here. Judging, it's safe to say, judging by tonight, that I think Jimmy probably had more friends and more fans than anyone I know.
Yeah!
And I'm proud to say I was a friend of his.
Yeah!
The guy always had a twinkle in his eye. He always had a smile on his face. He always seemed to be having such a damn fucking good time. He'd come up to me and he'd say, "Look, John, I just spoke to my Uncle Warren. I don't know about you guys, but he got me convinced they were related. Because they were both so damn smart. So I'm hoping they're going to give me some investment advice." But actually, Jimmy would end up saying, because he came to a couple of my matches, he'd say, "Relax, man. You're too fucking wound up." And of course he was right. So about the last 15, 20 years since I've been around Jimmy, I've tried to live by his credo. If Cameron, you're out there, he came up to me years ago, he said, "Hey, listen, my son's playing a little tennis, can you take a look at it? Stick to singing." No, I'm kidding, Cameron, if you're there, love you. I mean, one of the greatest guys I've ever met is Jimmy Buffett, and I'm glad that I'm here tonight. Thank you.
Yeah.
I'd now like to welcome a world-class, worldwide entertainer, Mr. 305, it's Pitbull!
Just 'cause you make me, don't hate me. As a matter of fact, you should take me, even if you don't, so welcome, yeah.
John McEnroe for the introduction. I want to say thank you to all of the lady for having us here tonight. It's such an amazing night celebrating somebody so special like Jimmy Buffett.
Yeah!
He's the definition of what it is to unite, not divide. He brought everybody together, no matter where you're from, what you represent, religion, culture, creed. And that's priceless. I want to say thank you to the Coral Reefs Band for having us here tonight. What an honor to be on the same stage. But let me tell you, while the whole world shut down, me and Jimmy Buffett ran into each other in Nashville, Tennessee. Which I call it Cashville, Tennessee. We were staying in the hotel, the same hotel. He didn't know I was there. I didn't know he was there. All I know is I ended up having a meeting, somebody let him know where I was at, and Jimmy popped up. And he popped up and he said, "And what the fuck are you doing here?" He said, "These ain't your parts, my Cubano friend." I said, "Man, it's crazy. You know, I just partnered up with a NASCAR and a NASCAR team called Track House." Then he said, "What the fuck are you doing in NASCAR?" I said, "Jimmy, man, I'm just taking a page out of your book. But crazy enough, Jimmy, I got this song in my phone I've been working on for years at this point, which is called Thank God and Jimmy Buffett."
Yeah!
And Jimmy looked at me with that little smirk he's got and he said, "Now you're fucking with me." So I played it for him right there off of my phone, being one of the only people at that time to have a BlackBerry in the whole world. He said, "You know, I'm gonna have to get on that." So it's a blessing and honor to be able to perform Thank God and Jimmy Buffett here tonight.
Yeah!
And to everybody here, once again, thank you so much for the opportunity. And it's a true, true honor to be able to bring out the one and the only John Bon Jovi. Now Jimmy Buffett says it best. When you lose yourself, it's hard to find a key in paradise. Rest in paradise, Jimmy. Tonight we celebrate.
Thank God and Jimmy Buffett. I'm going to Mustache and Brandi. I'm turning on in a bucket. Thank God and Jimmy Buffett. What you got cooking? I got that big old beer. Must be your Mexican cutie. Everybody, put your hands up. Thank God and Jimmy Buffett.
Thank you, Armando. Yo, you can dance. I've known my friend Jimmy Buffett for some 20 years now. Jimmy loved to play, he lived to play, and he played to live. He gave me fashion advice and hair tips throughout the 20 years. He's the only guy I've ever met that used to show up to a picnic or a rock show dressed in the same clothes. And each one of us, you know, we walk around and we go, no, I'm a rock star, I'm a rock star. And then Jimmy Buffett walks in the room. He flies his own plane to his own show. That's a rock star. Jimmy Buffett is a rock star. Let me tell you something. I would sit at what we call the knee of the Jedi and ask advice of Jimmy. Life's lessons were learned with Jimmy. Last summer, we sat at his picnic table at his house, and he played me the mixes, Bubbles Up, and My Gummy Just Kicked In, and this whole new record. And I had the honor, privilege, and pleasure of calling him my friend for 20 years. And as he sat at that picnic table just last summer, he looked at me with that big shit-eating grin, and he says, I'm going back. We're going back. Let's get out there and rock these people again. I'm gonna be back. I'm gonna promote this record. He inspired the beautiful things in life. There's an old saying about seizing the day. Jimmy taught me to embrace the day, to enjoy the moments, to enjoy your family, to enjoy your friends. And it's been my honor and privilege to be here with you tonight and with the Coral Reefer Band. And Miss Jane, I love you. Thank you all. Have a great rest of your evening.
Yeah! Please welcome to the stage Judd Apatow and Leslie Mann.
Yeah!
I know. I got way too stoned on Jimmy's gummies backstage. Because I swear to God, I thought I just saw Snoop Dogg sing Gin and Juice with a Coral Reefer Band. We love Jimmy and Jane, and they're the most generous, wonderful people ever. I remember once we were in St. Bart's, and Jimmy said, do you want to fly with me? I have to practice landing at the airport 30 times. And I said, yeah. And it was fine. You did a good job. And the moral of the story is Will Arnett is a pussy. Be a man. Let's talk about this incredible band, everybody.
Yeah!
When you think of rock and roll stability, isn't usually what comes to mind. But Jimmy Buffett toured with his band, the Coral Reefers, consistently since 1975.
Yeah!
Mike Utley, they worked together
since 1973. Yeah! 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 1973. How long is that? Like 73 to 2000 is like 27, 23 years. How many years is that?
That's 50 years.
50 years. Jesus. Jimmy was the front man, but he knew better than anyone that it was the band that made it all work.
Yeah!
They were a second family, a community created on the road, bonded by an experience impossible to explain.
And by impossible to explain, we mean they got fucked up a lot together as a family. Jimmy was a deeply loyal collaborator and friend, and while he left us way too soon, the Coral Reefers are keeping his spirit alive.
Yeah!
Next time, the Coral Reefers on Jimmy's 1989 album, Off to See the Lizard, before her own career as a solo artist skyrocketed.
Let's welcome to the stage an honorary coral reefer and a one-of-a-kind artist, Cheryl Crow!
It is true! I got hired by Jimmy Buffett. He didn't know me from Adam in 1989 with a couple of, actually three of the Coral Reefers who are from St. Louis, some very, very dear friends. I was absolutely a nobody, and I got to sing backup on Off to See the Lizard with Timothy B. Schmidt.
Yeah!
But I have to preface the story by saying I came from St. Louis, I flew to Miami, I got a small commuter jet. We had a bomb scare. They flew us in 100 yards above the water. They foam landed us, and then the FBI showed up. And then forevermore, Jimmy would say, "This girl knows how to show up to a party." So, with that in mind, and actually, I will tell you, he is for me the most beautiful illustration of what it means to be alive and awake and absolutely present in every moment. And Jamie, I love you. I'm so happy to be a part of this. So how many of you guys are land sharks? Are you here with me?
Yeah!
I know you're parrots, but are you land sharks?
Yeah!
I need to see some fins. Yeah! I know we're in Hollywood, but I need to see some fins out, y'all. Alright, here's the thing, I know Jimmy is probably laughing his ass off right now with a big fat joint and a margarita, and he's watching y'all, so let's see some exercise. Let's hit it, guys.
Shut up, yeah. As it is,
Hello and welcome, everybody. We're all here tonight to celebrate the life and the music of Jimmy Buffett, our good friend. I miss the guy so much, but I think everyone does. Everyone who didn't even know Jimmy feels like he's a friend of theirs, and that's one thing he taught me very well, is to celebrate your life. I think Jimmy did it better than anybody. All the things he had, all the places he went, all the friends he had, he was connected to so many people every day, all the time. Always bringing smiles and good energy and good vibes to people. I don't think there's anybody here who wasn't personally touched by him in some way. Jimmy once invited me to come out to New York with him and go surfing, and I couldn't make it. And I remember him saying to me, you know, you gotta take advantage of these things while you got the opportunity, and there's only so much time we got here. And you know, he was keenly aware of the fact that life is fleeting and making memories is what we gotta do while we're here. So he taught me some good lessons there on Saturday to make that time, but we had some other great memories together. And I know everyone else here remembers a time or a place they were, or they were listening to Jimmy's music or were with him at that time. If there's one message Jimmy sends out to everyone, it's to celebrate your friends, spend all the good times with them, make great memories while we're here. Another great friend of ours here to celebrate is Jack Johnson. So welcome, Jack.
Aloha, how's everybody doing? What an honor to be here to celebrate such a great human. He's one of my favorite memories of Jimmy, and this will give you a good idea of the type of person he was. The first time he was ever coming over to my house, I tried to explain to him where the studio was. I was hanging out in the studio and he was gonna come. I heard the car show up, I heard the door shut and everything, but the door didn't open. I figured, okay, he missed the studio door, so I go walking over to my house, and he had gone in there, and my friend was over there watching my kids. My kids are real little, they're taking a nap or something. And I told my friend, Crystal, I said, hey, the toilet's clogged, and there's a plumber coming. And so anyways, you can already see where it's going. And so, by the time I see him already walk in the house, I missed my chance, so I follow him in, and she takes him right into the bathroom, and she points Jimmy to where the toilet was. She's like, it's this one right here. And as I walk in the house, I hear Jimmy, he's like looking at my toilet, and he's like, well, I didn't bring my tools today, but I could come back tomorrow. Anyways, he was like one of my dad's friends. He was just a normal old guy, and we miss him. Love you, Jimmy. This is a song, this is one of the first, this is probably the reason I kept playing music, is I learned how to play this song when I was 14 years old. Called Higher Looks of Ford. Yeah. Well, yes, I am a pirate. Whoa. I jumped ahead. They even got the teleprompter. Sorry, I was hanging out with Snoop Dogg backstage.
But Mother Ocean, I've heard you call. I wanted to sail upon your water since I was 3 feet tall. You've seen it all. You've seen it all. Watch the men who rode you switch from sails to steam. And in your belly you hold the treasure if you have ever seen. Most of them are dreams. Yeah, most of them are dreams. Well, yes, I. Don't wonder, there's nothing to plunder. I'm an over 40 victim of fame, arriving too late, arriving too late. See? my share of rest. Made enough money to buy Miami, but I pissed it away so fast. Stepped up to last.
Now it's never meant to last.
I am drunk now for over 2 weeks. I passed out and I rallied and I sprung a fuse. But I gotta stop wishing. I gotta go fishing. I'm down the rock bottom again. Just a few friends.
Yeah, just a few friends.
Several a while, and though I ran away, they come back one day. They still can manage a smile. Just takes a while. Just takes a while. Mother, Mother Ocean, after all these years I've found patience just not around. I feel like I'm drowned. I feel like I'm down.
We're just a few friends. We're just a few friends.
Yeah!
Mr. Zach Brown.
Yeah! One of the most badass motherfuckers that I know. He's not bad on the drums. And one of my favorite motherfuckers, Mr. Day Grohl.
Yeah.
Beatles and Paul McCartney.
Yeah, right?
You can't talk about it. What the fuck is that?
Dave Matthews! Oh my god!
Every time I show up Jimmy, he'd always say, where's Ashley? Ashley's my wife. And they got along just fine. But more seriously, every time I saw him, he was like, he treated me like an old friend. Even the first time we hung out, which was appropriately on an island in the sunshine. But he was such an amazing adventurer and entertainer for sure, but what a great human being, and I'm so grateful that I could be part of saying goodbye. I'm sorry I can't be there, but I'm glad that y'all let me send a postcard of sorts so I can feel involved. Love to his family and love to his friends and love to everybody. All the best, Jimmy.
Thank you.
breaking free.
Place in Snowmass up there in Aspen, Colorado. It was just for a casual dinner, and I showed up, and Jimmy, of course, was there, and Hunter Thompson, and Len Fry, and Don Henley, and Jack Nicholson. And, you know, just a casual dinner, Angelica Houston. And my sister, Miss Jane Buffett, was also there. And Jimmy was cooking, and he made some of the most delicious duck I've ever had. The flavors were so strong they were able to break through the insane amount of cocaine that we had done. Aspen in the 80s. Or 90s, or... Jimmy was a great host, but he was an even better friend. He always made sure that everyone was having the best possible time. He lit up the room with his stories, some of them fact and most of them fiction. And he turned those stories into best-selling books. So I want to read a little excerpt for you about our friend, Jimmy. And bear with me, I got to get through this. I've been called a lot of things in these 50 years on this good old earth, but the thing I am the most is lucky. I've always looked at life as a voyage, mostly wonderful, sometimes frightening. In my family and friends, I've discovered treasures more valuable than gold. I have seen and done things that I read about as a kid. I have dodged many storms and bounced across the bottom on occasion. But so far, Lady Luck and the stars by which I steer have kept me off the rocks. I paid attention when I had to, and I have made more right tacks than wrong ones to end up in this moment, with 1,000 ports of call behind me, and I hope 1,000 more to see. I was honored to dock in a lot of those ports with my friend Jimmy Buffett. And now, I want you to join me in welcoming to the stage a bunch of guys that we used to hang out with back in the day. You might have heard of them. They're just rock legends. Bring on the Eagles!
Thank you. be great.
Oh,
Childhood in Mississippi, he would say, I let my mind go where my feet couldn't carry me yet. But Jimmy's feet carried him far. Looking out on this audience tonight, I can see the impact he and his music have had on so many people. He's an inspiration, right? I mean, come on. Now, look at that.
Yeah.
A man who made his dreams come true. One of Jimmy's many dreams to come true was sharing the stage and studio with an idol and our next performer. It's my pleasure to bring out a dear friend of Jimmy's. Please welcome Sir Paul McCartney.
Pleasure knowing Jimmy, and like everyone else on the bill tonight has said,
This is one great man. He was generous, he was funny, he'd done just about everything in his life. And like I say, he was so generous. I was on holiday with him and I forgot to bring my guitar. So he had his own guitar strung left-handed for me. Yeah. So, and then the next time I saw him, he had one custom made, left-handed, for me. So, I love Jimmy, and love you too. So, in the last week of his life, I was invited up to his house by Janie. And by the way, this wouldn't have happened tonight. Let's hear it for Janie.
Yeah! Woo!
And I was invited up there to sing a couple of songs for Jimmy. And he was in a pretty bad way, but he still had that twinkle in his eye. So I thought I'd sing one of those songs that I sang to him tonight.
Thank you.
You guys ever seen anything like this?
No!
Unbelievable. That's a nice thing about a Jimmy Buffett show. I rode shotgun with the guy for 4 decades, and every time he ever stood right here, he gave 100% of everything he had, which made us give 100% of everything that we had. And you guys gave us 100% back. And it was this big alternating current of positive energy. And we left every show wired to the gills, mostly legally. Mostly. But this one is special. Bubba, can you believe this, Jimmy? Well, the last thing Jimmy did, introduced this wonderful coral reefer band, and I'm going to do that right now. It's a lot harder from the middle of the stage. I like standing next to Jimmy, but tonight, I'm going to do my best. Mr. Eric Darkin on percussion back here behind us. Yeah. On steel drums, the one and only Robert Grimes. Los Angeles, California, via Trinidad. We have a steel section. Mr. Doyle Grisham on the steel guitar over there. Yeah. On the drums, Roger Guth. Yeah. One man trumpet section, Mr. John Level on the trumpet over here. Woo. Bass player, Jim Mayer. Guitar player after my own heart, Mr. Peter Mayer on the lead guitar. Yeah. Newest coral reefer, hell of a singer, great buddy. This is Scotty Emerick right here. Yeah. The one and only Jake Simabukuro right here. Yeah. We got the lovely reeferess, Miss Tina Gullickson, Los Angeles, California. Miss Nadira Shakur. Yeah. And Miss Caroline Jones has a brand new baby, and I'm not sure she's still up with us, but she's awesome. Oh, here's Caroline. Come on. Yeah.
Our musical captain, who's helped each and every one of us tonight on stage sail in the right direction, one of the greatest guitar players, singer, songwriters on earth, Mac McAnally. Yeah!
Woo! And our musical director the entire time that I've been in the Coral Reefer Band, Mr. Michael Utley back here. And because he wasn't satisfied with his share of the Coral Reefer Band, he's worked his son into the band. And my son-in-law, this is Mick Utley right here. Yeah! We're going to bring out some guest Jimmy Buffetts here. And we're going to sort of gang up and sing the national anthem of Margaritaville.
Yeah!
Seems like the right thing to do. Come on, folks. Angelique, Kidjo, Brandi, Carlile, Timothy, Schmidt, there's John Bon Jovi. Hey, there's Frank Marshall.
Somebody call security. This is a man with a margarita right here.
Yeah!
We've got McEnroe. There's some eagles. I'm just going to shut up and have chill bumps until everybody gets in front of a microphone, I think. It's pretty amazing.
Appreciate the whole Buffett family, the children, Savannah, Delaney, Cameron, God bless you. Jane Buffett, this one's for you.
Yeah!
Jimmy Buffett, get a big kick out of this game. Let's all sing Margaritaville. Raise a glass.
Yeah. In an all-small state,
next time.